Still can't control the car yet. Yeah, I definitely need practice on. Whoa! No, it's not. I know exactly where I am. Maybe I'm pushing the car a little bit too hard. Alright, actually I don't want to spend too much time practicing this time. Oh, okay. Gosh dang it. Make up your mind, car. It's like it's starting to want to drift. All I did was turn down the body roll a little bit. The roll bars in the front are a little bit softer now. That's it. And it made a huge difference. Oh, dang it. Alright. I had enough of practice. Skip to end the session. Alright. Continue the qualifying. Today at school, we worked on changing and rotating and all that, the tires on the car, using the machines and all that stuff. And I got dirty, man. Just touching those tires. Yeah, I dropped one of them on my foot, and it was a complete, like, whole tire with, like, what was it? It was an aluminum tire, not a steel one. So it wasn't that heavy, but it hurt. I fell on my foot. Goodness. It hurt really bad. Okay, so what is the point of... This is the last day of the season. And that's cut, not it. Alright. Yeah, I kind of just skip over practice now at this point. Did my body just shake? What's going on? Don't you dare. Get back on there. Try to keep it PG. Oh yeah, I'm passing you up, buddy. Come on.
Good luck. Give it everything on your hot lap. You can do this.
Dang it. This car will rip you out. It's like, don't ever try to countersteer a front wheel drive car if you're in a drift. You just gotta let it ease back onto the street like that. Cause this car, like, gets me every time. First of all, why is it drifting? That is a big issue for a front wheel drive car to be pulling like that. Cause it's not understeering, so it can't be an all wheel drive. So this car is just trying to kill me. Man, you just need to get out of the way at this point. What are you doing? What are you doing? My car is trying to kill me. I'm glad I'm messing up like this, because I actually don't want to be in 20th place anymore. They just move out of your way in this game. Oh, but you want to know? A game I'm really excited about, excuse me, is Dirt Rally. I think I want to pick that game up. Seems like it'd be really fun to play, especially if I like this game. They say it's more realistic than Dirt 3. I haven't played Dirt 3 in a while, but that's also one of my favorite games of all time, actually. There you go. Coming for you, bro. Nah, you ain't getting away from me. I don't care how bad this car's trying to kill me. Thank you. So, gotta get better internet connection. And I gotta say, I'm about out of energy. But I'm gonna beat this last day of the season. And then I'm gonna race that McLaren F1 again. Can't believe it. I can't drive a McLaren P1, which is state-of-the-art technology. Like, the best in its class, almost. And yet, I can't drive it as good as I drive the almost... How old would the McLaren be? F1 be? Almost 20 years old, right? Or 17 or something like that. I can drive that car perfectly fine. Can't drive, cannot drive the new P1 at all. Spin it like 8 times in a row, and it's just not, it doesn't look good for me. It doesn't do good for me, I should say. And I'm about had it with this Renault. It's not, I didn't like this car that much from the get-go. I'd much rather be in something like a BMW, rear-wheel drive, or all-wheel drive, because racing front-wheel drive is too predictable and easy, except for when you spin out. That's unpredictable. But basically in these cars, you can't control that. If they want to spin, they're going to spin. It's gotten to the point where I am used to the car almost now. Because now I know when to shift it usually without looking at the little indicator just by sound, so. Not good at rev matching yet. That's something I need to practice. Can you believe this thing only has 219 horsepower? The original one has 258 or something like that. This one doesn't have that much horsepower. Has a lot of torque, but... surprising how low the horsepower is. Now, I wouldn't complain if I was driving this thing in real life, don't get me wrong. I'm just saying, in the game, it's missing that fun factor. I do like how it sounds outside the car. Let me see, let me show you. Oh. You hear that? Actually, for some reason it sounds like a fart can to me today. I don't know why. It usually doesn't. Maybe because it's not backfiring. There we go. That's what I like to hear. I hope in the next game they make of this. They add customization, amongst other things. This is actually, I think the...
Okay, that's qualifying over.
I think that's as much as you can do. I don't even know if you can change the livery or anything. Ninth? That's actually great. That's great. I can deal with 8 people in front of me. The other 19, not so much. All right. All right, I'm coming through, bro. Riding that rev limiter. Dude, y'all taking a turn like a bunch of pansies. It's so funny how the race makes such a big difference then. Cause now I'm in first place and I'm stomping him now. Crazy. But they did say to end the season off strong, and I did want to be placed somewhere near the middle instead of all the way in last like last time. Kind of makes me want to play F-Zero X. I never fully beat that game, man. And it bothers me to the end of this. To this day, I have not finished that game. Oh. I need to slow down, don't I? I'm also going to say something. Since being a simulator, since the weather has effect in the game, I think you start in the early morning when you first race, right? So what I'm thinking is, the reason I'm doing so well now is because my tires have more grip. I'm not sliding around as much.
3 seconds. Protect that gap.
Wow. Well, you had to say something. Ow. Wow. That went down quickly. Oh, I hear you. I gotta regain these positions, hold on. I'll finish my story in a second about the tires. So I'm thinking that the reason my tires are so good now and aren't sliding around like they just did was because the weather is nicer. But I think that's wrong too. That's actually... What are you doing? I am so sorry. I did not realize you were in the grass. And I was preventing you from coming inside. That's one way to win a race. I should have downshifted a long time ago. Well, that didn't go as planned. Neither did that. Why am I losing control all of a sudden? This is a great question. Why am I easily passing this guy up as if he has a slower car than mine?
You're up to first place. Great job. Keep pushing.
He going? Did I push him in there? No, he's behind me. Okay. I think I got first place. I think I did. I don't know. That guy might have cheated and took a shortcut. Yeah, I got first place. $239 points for the season, dog. I can't believe it. They put me in 14th now? Why? Why?
We've made it to the final race. Go and wrap it up. Green, green, green.
I gotta kill y'all now. Dude, they are like afraid of me or something. Am I like the known guy? I kill everybody, don't I? Oh, he got scared. He was out. Usually this is where they have this weird phenomenon. I wonder if they got a warning for cutting the track. Dude! I was controlling his car with mine. I'm so aggressive. It's so funny because on Need for Speed Shift, I was like totally 100% precision that whole game. And then when it comes to video games, I guess I'm just really aggressive. Like, I don't really care what happens to the car because it's not real. Same thing when I went go-karting a long time ago. People would hit me and I'd just be keep going. It's gonna be, I'm taking my line. I'm not gonna chicken out of it. That's just how I am, I guess. But that's probably not gonna be very good for me later down the line in my career. Whatever I'm driving, unless it's rally, which I doubt. What was that noise? Unless it's rally, which I doubt will be like that. Sorry, you got too close, sir. Lap 2, let's go.
You're leading by 1 second. Try and push the gap open.
It's like they all lose their nerve or something around that corner. That's the same corner I pass them up at. Same corner I lose them at. I think I'm doing pretty good though for somebody who's a rookie at this kind of stuff. It's not like I'm using a controller, I'm using the, well, the steering wheel is actually better to me. But it's not the steering wheel I want, but it's what I got. But usually on the remote control, you can do a lot more stuff with that remote control. Like over here, I got like map a handbrake or something. I don't know where it is.
Box now, box now. You must pit for your mandatory change of tires.
Some reason, he is so loud in my headset that he throws me off every time. This is not a lie. That is the truth, because last time, it's like, either I tune him out or I crash. 1, 2. Well, that was weird. Just glitched in there. What's the front of my car look like? I can't see the front of my car, apparently. Yes, I'm going, mate. Yeah, I kind of messed that up. It's not good. It's not good, mate, is it? Who is this green guy? Is he my friend? Because I assumed the red guy was my rival. Either he's my teammate or something. This is a long way from being, not grid, but, yeah, grid, I was right. This is a long ways from being grid, but it's more realistic than grid. But the damage, to make a perfect racer, they need to combine, let's see, Midnight Club, GTA, BeamNG Drive, and Project Cars, and you'll have the perfect game. And The Sims, I forgot The Sims. Combine those 5 games, and you'll have the best game ever. guarantee it. Most complicated, the best game ever. Can simulate everything. Combine all the simulators into one game. Call it The Sims Free For All or something, I don't know. It'd be the best simulator ever.
Your fastest lap in the race so far.
How is that even possible? I don't know if I drive this car in real life either, though. Like, to be 100% honest, it's like literally, you know how they say it's not their cup of tea? It's literally not my cup of tea. I like hatches, but I'm more of a golf guy. And like, it's just doesn't look the way I would like it to look, you know? And plus, I don't even know if we get these in America now I think about it. So I could be complaining about nothing. But this game has a lack of freaking any other car besides European and some American. That was bad. I wonder if they write that up. Dump the clutch. Destroyed the gears. He did not rev match while downshifting. Engine blew up.
This is the final lap of the race. See if you can take that guy in front of you, otherwise just bring it back in one piece.
Already did, he's gone.
Teammates up to P5, we're in a good points position.
Oh yes, not just me anymore. It's a team thing again. That's what Grid Autosport was like. I'm almost getting the hang of this. Like 100%.
5 seconds behind you, let's keep in there.
Don't interrupt me again. You make me spin out. If I wasn't on a straight, I would have spun out. There's two reasons I spin out. It's because the freaking subs. The subtitles are there. And I'm listening too much. Oh, it's over. Oh, you can't see that.
You did it! Your first Korean championship! Congratulations, mate! That was a top job out there!
What? Never mind. West side. I don't know what I'm doing. Well, Rockford Rennsport. So I won both races.
Fantastic! You've won your first championship. Make sure to check your inbox, as you will no doubt have received new contract offers. You can also renew your contract with your current team and stay on for another season.
No. I love y'all, but no.
That was so loud. Ooh. Ooh. Oh.
It's a nice trophy. I give you trophies in this game. That's beautiful. 273 points. I bet you there's people who had like perfect scores on here. I don't even know where you go with touring after this. Because they only had like one option for touring. That was at Renault. There was no other cars I was racing against.
And this game is weird because I find it easier to race faster cars.
You have reached the end of the season. Please review your contract offer. Sign a new contract at Kennedy next season. Award gold allocated for winning the UK Clio Cup. Yeah. Oh man, this is already hurting me. Here at Torque Riders, we would honor if you would accept an offer to come and drive for us next year. Torque Riders has a competitor GT5 for competitor in GT5. Okay. Now, and has a strong heritage of family and openness. With our engineering team already hard at work on further improvements in our Ginetta G40 Junior, chance of success next season with your help. This unanimous decision, we would kindly like to extend an offer to you to drive for final drive next season. As you may know, oh gosh, this is actually hurting me. Final drive has established in 2004, has been a key force in the Formula Golf ever since. For very competitive Formula Golf 1000. And behind, with you behind the wheel, we believe the team and the car would be capable of winning the next championship. We'd be honored if you would consider joining us. Oh, even though it's fake, it feels so good. Here at Silverback, we are honored if you would accept an offer to come to drive with us next year. Silverback has a competitive Formula Golf for 23 years now and has a strong heritage of family openness with our engineering team ready, hard at work on further improvement of Formula Golf 1000. We believe that we have a strong chance of success next season with your help and expertise. Real UK contract renewal offer on behalf of Rockford Rennsport. I am kindly informing you that we would like to extend the contract very close to next season. We believe that we can be even more competitive in the future, and you are a key part of our strategy. That is not good. You're hurting me again. Happy for you. You did it. How does champion sound in front of your name? See you at the party, Ronnie Marshall. Yeah, we gonna party. Fist pump. Yeah, okay, whatever. All right. It's a long season. We all started turning to focus. Was everybody smiling and winking? And we all started with hope and turned into focus. Yeah. And drive as we started to get points on board. Here's to the future. Enjoy the postseason. Mate, we're over the moon for you. John Bentley's throwing a party tonight to dust off your smartest, as we're going to celebrate the best team, the best driver. Gosh dang, these are some messages. Words cannot express how happy we are right now, and I hope we showed that in the team paddock. Oh gosh, there's a lot going on. Straight after the race, winning the championship was a feat on its own, but placing the Constructor AE's championship, blah blah blah, the true reflection of teamwork both on the track and behind the scenes. We're all excited for what the future holds now. Okay, I'm new to all the new racing Gizmos. I'm new to all the racing terminology, so I would like to find out. I'm on my phone right now, about to search it. What GT5 is? What is GT5? Not Gran Turismo. Okay. Formula Golf or Formula... What is a Ginetta G400Z? Starks takes the win! Wow. This is what the life is going to be like. Yeah, I can't wait. All right, final drive. Which one was the one where they used the words family? Here to Yeah, I'll go with Torque Riders for once.
Welcome to GT5 Class Racing, your entry point into the world of Grand Touring Racing. This is a single championship sport, where you'll be driving the Ginetta G40 against a field of identical cars. Each round features a sprint race and a main race. All race finishers will earn points, and bonus points are awarded for the fastest qualifying time and fastest race lap time. There's a mandatory pit stop during the main race. The pit lane is always open for refueling, repairs, and tire changes.
This game is real.
It's time to start your grand touring career.
That is a beautiful car. Oh, why you do that? Why you do that? Always on Pete Boris. Yeah, Boris. Okay. If you're on board, I just know you're going to make our Ginetta G40 Junior sing with joy. I'm glad to do that for you, guy. I'll be there to make sure everything under the hood keeps running. I could do that. I could probably do that. Never mind. I'll let you. I'm focused on the racing. Thank you for being on my team. You just keep your pedal to the metal and win us this championship. See you at the track. Torque Riders, so you have us as our lead driver. Thanks for accepting our offer. This is an exciting season ahead of us with you on board. We're feeling very confident that we can win this one. Let's do this. Go do this. Joey Negri. Hey, man. Sorry to hear you're leaving. It was a bit of shock to us, to be honest, but we respect your decision. Hopefully, we won't be driving against you in the future season. All the best, Ronnie Marshall. Hey, everyone. Sorry to hear that you're going to be moving on, but I completely understand. The Rockford Series 14 won't be the same without you. All the best of you. Ah, why? Why did they do this to me? See, this is stuff that gets me all emotional, man. It's like, oh, man. Y'all got me started. Then I got to move on. I don't know what to do, man. I could have kept racing for him, but Ronnie was weird, man. I don't know. I'm just tired of your freaking, whatchamacallit. Okay. Well, I think that's it for today. We get to start the new season next Monday. Excuse me. Let's do a little bit of free practice, and I want to get this Ginetta. Wait, I'm going the wrong way. No, I'm going the right way. Ah, why does the GT3 look so okay? Never mind. So here's what I'm saying. Next Monday, be back on it. Next season, straight onto it.
I got some editing to do for this last D for Speed episode.
I'm also looking for an editor. unfortunately, yes, you have to be free until I start making some money. I don't know how I'm gonna do that on YouTube, but I'm looking for an editor that I can send the videos to, and they can send it back to me edited. With soon to have work, and all I have time to do is play. So we'll find it out. Okay. Okay. Interesting. Oh, whoa. You're spitting a lot of flames there. I like that. Now I'm assuming you're rear-wheel drive. You're actually slower than the Alpine, it feels like. Oh yeah. But it turns so easily, I can't explain. It grips too. That's surprising. I was not expecting this thing to grip. Dang. Why is it so loud in here? Oh! My ears are bleeding. Wow. Surprising. That was quite surprising. Expecting this thing to spin out. What? Oh yeah, I definitely have to get used to this car. Because apparently I could have took that turn without even slowing down. Alright, I'm done playing around. Let's see what this thing can do. Whoa, dude. Stay on the track. Whoa, this thing is gripped. This is stuck to the floor. What? Oh, man. I only have to brake. What is this? It's not going that fast. I realize that. Okay. So, with all the noise, it feels like it's going a lot faster than it is. I don't have to slow down. Witchcraft. There's no way this thing is this good. It's like making me smile. I'm trying not to, but... This thing is crazy. How much does this cost? It's like magic. This is crazy. And it just sounds like crap on the outside. What? So loud. Watch. Do you see this? I try to take that corner of any other car flying away. Like, I'm off. Not. No, just dead. one of these. It doesn't go that fast, but boy, can it handle. I wonder if this is what it's like to drive an S2K. Oh! Smack! Oh, I have to slow down. I'm not going to slow down then. Yeah. I admit, I'm not going as fast as I think I am. But it's still incredible. And it can break. I think what it is a normal motor, light car, but like, class, everything is classed above. Like, these brakes are probably off of, like, a Bugatti or something. So, brakes just fine. The tire's probably from the Bugatti, too. So, they don't lose traction. And they don't spin, because it's not enough horsepower. Incredible. I want one now. Hey. I forgot what the handbrake is. Handbrake, found it. You can't drift it any at all. Like, there's no possibility of doing that. I just tried to. Well. Wow. I have to say, this car is crazy. And it looks so innocent. I have to see the specs in this car, because this is crazy. Only 107? It's only 100 horsepower. Do you see that? That turn in. Okay, I think I just need to exit this real quick and pull out another car that I know is at least twice as fast as this car. And yes, it is a McLaren. But this is going to take a long time. I'm trying not to fall asleep. Come on. I need a racing chair. This is like the weirdest setup. Okay, so that thing is crazy. Yeah, go down. This thing. Can I change that? No, I can't. Okay. Same track. I'm gonna try the same corner. I think it's T between is as before T1. I think that's it. Yeah, it's before T1. That corner right there. World's deadliest corner. This music though is like too epic for this game. Makes you feel like you're doing a lot more than you are, but you're not. Yes, I need this. My brakes are up to temperature. I'm not even using them yet. Hello. Somebody was not happy to see me today. He's like, back for more, eh? This car is a lot heavier. A lot more momentum being pushed around. Four times the power. That's why I find that little car incredible. You get used to cars like... Actually, this car handles very good compared to the other cars I drive. I love this car. Aw, there's like nothing more, nothing I want more than this car. Nothing I want more. Oh. Compared to that Jetta, this thing is crazy. You see how I brake? It's because I'm used to these cars. But in that Jetta, you don't have to brake at all. Almost panicked there. I don't know why. I saw red. I assumed I was going to die. Oh, this thing sounds beautiful on the inside. Surprisingly quiet. Oh, you know why? I forgot to mid-engine. They got these sounds down pat though. Ooh, see? Can't do that in this car. You cannot do that in this car. I knew I was about to die on that corner. There's no doubt about that. This car sounds good, but I wonder what the Huayra sounds like in this game. Is the shifter on my right side? You know, that is so bizarre. Oh, yeah. Had too much faith. Overconfident.